And the answer is, select star from art, order by created descending. Okay, so remember our table is called art. I hope I didn't confuse you by adding the S here. I think we will accept both. But our class name is art, and so that's the name of the table. So select star from art. And remember, all GQL queries have to say select star. So you had no choice there. And then order by, that's how you sort something, created. And this is our property that represents when this particular piece of art was submitted. And since we want most recent first, we add des for descending at the end of this query. Okay, let's go ahead and add this to our program. Okay, so I've written the SQL, select star from art, order by created descending. You know, I use multiple lines here. It makes it a little bit easier to read. And that's going to store this the result from this query, which is actually going to be a cursor. A cursor is just a pointer to the results in this variable called arts. And let's go ahead and pass in arts to our template. And let's go to our template and make use of it. So below our form, this is going to get a little fancy. We're going to display all the artwork we've received submitted. So I'm going to start with an HR, which just draws a line across the page. And then I can use a loop in this template. Now this is going to be actually, it's going to be Python code embedded in our HTML. You don't have to understand it, but that's what I'm doing. For art in arts, this little curly percent syntax is used by Jinja, the template language, to separate HTML from Python. We're going to create a div. We're going to call it art. Remember, this class doesn't do anything until we add the styles, and we haven't added any styles yet. So it basically just creates a new line. Div class equals art title. Again, another div doesn't do anything yet. We're just going to put the art title in here. This is how we include a variable. Remember the double curlies. So for art in arts, I'm going to take that art here and access its title. And this object art here is actually an instance of this class art here, and it has a title. So we can access the title using the period syntax. Then we close those curlies, we close our div, and then we're going to add the art body. I'm going to use the pre tag. The pre tag is a handy little tag that basically preserves the white space that is inside it. So remember how we talked about HTML, how it converts all spaces to a single space and all new lines to a single new line? That's why we can, you know, indent our HTML, because there's actually all these spaces between all these tags and things just print as you'd expect them to. The pre-tag basically says anything with any white space between this pre-tag is pre-formatted, and it's going to stay that way. And so we're going to include our art.art. Now remember, this art here, this is a little confusing, I realize. This art here refers to this instance of our art class. And our art class actually has a property called art, which is actually the text of the art itself. So that's what we're going to include there. And then we're going to close our div. And we're going to end our loop. And that's the end of our HTML file. Let's review what we just added. For every art in arts, render this HTML. Remember, arts comes from this query that we run here, this GQL query, to select all of the art. We're going to store that in a variable called arts, and we're going to pass it into our template. Okay, so let's go to our browser. Here we've got our page, and now when I reload this page, I should see all of our artwork. Haha! And here is the camel we submitted. There's the title, and there's the camel. Let's submit a new piece of art.